Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin. Everyone, I'd like you to meet my friend Graham. Now, don't be alarmed. He isn't sick or injured or anything. Actually, quite the opposite. He was designed by Melbourne, Australia's Transport Accident Commission when they decided to find out what humans would look like if they evolved to survive car crashes. You humans are actually really bad at driving safely. People text, drive drunk, speed, and don't wear seatbelts. Compared to other similar high-income countries, the US has the most deadly car crashes each year, with 40,000 fatal accidents just in 2017. When your vehicle is slammed into something else, whether it's another car, a tree, or a barrier, a lot of things can happen to your body. Thankfully, cars are built to absorb a good amount of the force from the collision in areas called crumple zones, but they're clearly not perfect. The energy of an accident still shakes the people inside, often severely injuring the occupants. Where the car comes in contact with another object dictates where the brunt of the force will be delivered and how the occupants of the car will be thrown about. So, when a car crashes into something headfirst, people often slam into the steering wheel or front panel and experience chest and lower limb injuries like broken ribs or crushed legs. Whereas getting hit from the side will launch you away from the impact, and common injuries include head, chest, and lower extremity problems. Rear-end crashes jolt you forward and are notorious for neck and back injuries like whiplash. And finally, rollover accidents result in people being jostled about like they're being shaken in a snow globe. These crashes are typically accompanied with head and chest injuries. Obviously, things like where you're sitting, how fast the car was moving, and if you were wearing a seatbelt all play a big part in whether you survive or not. And the severity of these injuries is heavily dependent on seatbelt use. When I get into a car, one of the first things I do is buckle my seatbelt, just like 90% of Americans. But for those 10% that think they're too cool for seatbelts, they're twice as likely to die in a car crash. And wearing your seatbelt incorrectly can also cause huge problems. If it's too high and rests around your stomach, the belt could rip apart your inner organs in an accident. You know, I do say learning is fun, but this is also terrifying. It's also known that during a traumatic event like a car crash, your brain can go into fight or flight mode and focus on how to survive versus storing memories. This leads to people not remembering horrific accidents and what happened after. People can also suffer from PTSD and flashbacks of a car crash for years after it occurred. But the good news is that you can very easily reduce your likelihood of being in an accident and your chance of sustaining serious injuries. Wear your seatbelt, follow the speed limit, and for Pete's sake, keep your eyes on the road. Seriously, I don't want Pete getting injured. He's a great guy too. What else do you want to know about the human body? Let us know in the comment section below, or tell us, what should we talk about next? Curious to know how self-driving cars actually work? Check out this video. So, it's possible that well-made self-driving cars could drastically decrease that number. But also, these cars could make driving possible again for people who couldn't drive otherwise, like the visually impaired or elderly. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.